some of our colleagues who are far away, because as a network, as an online network, we tend to be geographically separated. And we use a peer assist process to help and support each other. And so what I'm going to do with you this afternoon is to kind of talk you through what this process involves, and we'll try it out with our three volunteers to see what comes out of it, and for you to understand the process and get a sense of how you might use it in other instances. We've been using this methodology both in a face-to-face situation like this, plus online, where we've got people in different places coming online at the same time to work this process to support usually one of their peers who has a challenge that they'd like to get some insights and some inspiration about. So it's a very useful process. You know how it is, you're working on something and you get very stuck. And you tend to keep thinking about the problem and not getting any really fresh insights. This process is really good at helping you interrogate your own thinking and maybe even get you to rethink things whilst you're also getting insights and inspiration from your peers. Now, what you're seeing up on the screen is a sketch note that our wonderful sketch noter Nicola did for us last year at e-learning 2015. Basically, the process is a simple one. Somebody comes forward with a challenge that they are facing. You present your challenge, right? It doesn't have to be a long story, maybe about 5 minutes. Basically tell people what it is you're doing, what you're trying to achieve, and tell them what you've done so far. Then you have a round whereby the people who are listening to you and to what you're doing ask you questions of clarification, all right? Just to make sure that they're getting the story right and everything, all right? After which, and maybe make suggestions, not necessarily suggestions that are going to give answers to what the problem is, but just suggestions on maybe how one might think about what you're doing differently. When that is done, the person whose peer assisted is gets to quickly revisit what they've heard from other people and basically give a short reflection on what they think about what they've heard. And then you go into another session with the group where you now start taking another look at what it is you think you're doing now and getting suggestions from people about how you might approach it. But the purpose of it really is to gain assistance and insights from others. It's not a review. And I think we need to go into this knowing that we're not pointing fingers, we're not assessing what that person is doing, we're seeking to help that person think about what they're doing and how they might achieve what they're hoping to achieve. It serves to identify possible approaches, solutions, or even new lines of inquiry. One might decide to go down a different road after having heard from people. It's about a sharing learning. It's a learning process, not only for the person whose peer assisted is, but it's a learning process for the people that actually agree to participate in it. And in so doing, you're knowledge sharing, it's participatory listening. I think the tendency here is when we hear people's issues, we want to jump in and have something to say. But I think what we need to do for this process is initially to listen and make sure we understand what we're hearing before we respond. And it helps to develop networks. I think in having these sort of interactions with people that are in different places that come together to help you, you learn about them and what they know. Now, oh, where are we? Sorry. So we've got some guidelines, some basic rules for the process, and we're not going to keep you long. The process is about 40-50 minutes, all right? You need, as the presenter or the person who has the issue, be willing to share experiences and lessons learned, and vice versa. You need to listen and learn. You need to be prepared to share knowledge and experiences relating to the challenge in question. And I think what's important here is that whatever is presented here as suggestions should not be increasing your workload. They should be helping you think through more effectively and do more effectively whatever it is you're trying to achieve. So basically, these are the processes that we're going to work through. We'll have each volunteer sit at a particular table with a group of people. In that group, there's of course the volunteer who has who's requesting or needing a peer assist. We would need to have somebody at the table who's basically tracking what is said and helping to facilitate the process. And then we'd start off by basically presenting your challenge and your hope for objectives. Not a long story, short stuff. The people at the table will listen until you're finished, and then we'll ask questions of clarification on the challenges, and maybe even question you on the assumptions on which you based this issue. It's a discussion. And then you'd be expected to think through what they've told you and basically come back with some sort of response about maybe change direction and you're rethinking things. And then the group will then listen to what you've got to say then and will come up with, I shouldn't be saying, let me use the word potential solutions, but basically suggestions about how we might proceed. Okay, they may not be able to give you any real solutions or answers, but they'll give you feedback that will guide you to move forward where you've been stuck. And then the stuff that I put in red is stuff that we do when we do the online event, because we're not sitting here together face to face. And so usually what happens is we have Nicola sitting in also online. She makes a diagram like you saw, a sketch note of the process, what she pulled out of it. And we share the notes, the illustrations, and so on through our various forum and platforms. We also record what we're doing so that anybody who missed can go back and listen to what happened during that event. And then if somebody feels that they benefited from the process, they can arrange to do a follow-up session that will take them to the next level. But it's a fairly simple, straightforward process. So what I'd like us to do is as groups is to get our volunteer to present the issue to the team, and we need to have one person who is dedicated to facilitate the progress. So, Gabby, you facilitate over there for that group, okay? And Jerome, you facilitate this one, and okay. And then Jacob will facilitate the other one. So, and then we'll work our way through the process step by step. Let's try and aim to be finished, please. Well, if we can do it like in 40 minutes, that would be great, but let's aim to not do this beyond 4 o'clock, all right? Are there any questions that you'd like to ask?